he keep India from bronze? No, he can't! Rupinder Pal! Well, who would have believed it, the game he had tonight?
Can Rupinder pull a goal back for India? Sweeps towards goal. Yes, he can. The crowd cheered. India finally managed to get a goal in this match in the very last minute.
Out it comes.
There's some strength through the goalkeeper. On England at the level. And it's Kate Richardson-Walsh, their captain, who's done the business for England. And I don't think the Scottish keeper there, Amy Gibson, will be pleased with that one, Mel.
No, it's come to the right-hand side as we're looking. But I think, in fairness to Amy Gibson, she's expecting there to be a touch. I think it's from probably Susie Gilbert, which is why she's decided to stand up.
Shot on target. First penalty corner of the day for Great Britain. 1-0 they lead. Kate Richardson-Walsh with the slap, takes a deflection, pings in off the crossbar, and Great Britain have a superb second here. It's Great Britain 2, South Africa 0. Pitches this one off the end of his stick, and that one does find the back of the net. But it really was just a matter of time, converting at the fourth time of asking. Gonzalo Payet makes it Argentina 1, Germany 0.
Here we go then. Second penalty corner, a little shift to the left. Payet, stop this time. It's in! And in the face of adversity, Argentina take the lead. Caglioni now comes back onto the park, but David Carter, in the Canadian goal, is beaten.
Here he is. First opportunity to unleash that drag flick in this game tonight. Weight to the top comes to him, sweeps towards goal, and somehow went underneath Shimamoto. And look what Carlos Rettigi feels. The pressure has been released, and you would think that that is it for Japan.
Argentina has the chance. Pelanz. Oh, he is on fire this tournament. What a finish! Make it 5 for the tournament for Gonzalo Pelanz, and the first opportunity today, he ranks it into the top.
It's going to be Julian Muller. Yes! Through the keeper, straight through Sakia Asano. She'll be really disappointed with that. She's had a good tournament, but that is a poor save.
Change of pace here from Caliber, pulls the ball back, there's a chance to take the lead! What a goal from Jeroen Hertzberger, gets the opener here, his second of the tournament, the Netherlands first of the night. It's Germany 0, Netherlands 1.
Watch here, feeding it to Ingles in the corner. Oh, all the way through, Hertzberger through on Manchester on the reverse stick. What a finish that is from Jeroen Hertzberger. What a ball that was from Kemperman.
Really applied a great deal of pressure in the second half. Given away possession now, Rebecki surges forward, the captain of Argentina, goes onto the backhand, shoots, and Rebecki scores and completes a hat-trick. And just as you were saying, Marsha, the USA deserved to score. An exclamation mark on Argentina's performance from their captain.
This is the quality of Carla Rebecki, and that's exactly why you'd want her in your team. Just staying disciplined, making that intercept at the halfway line, and with her change of pace, she just attacks the circle.
And again, a chance in front of goal, and he scores! Carla Rebecki for Argentina. Argentina 1, Korea 1.
A really clever piece of play by Sharon Lucchetti, and a clinical finish by Carla Rebecki.
Oh,
to seal the deal for the Netherlands.
Privilege of watching him next to us here as Netherlands come in there looking to get an opening goal, and what a tight angle that was from Van Aas inside the first minute. Desperately need to get this into the D. Denea, route one ball, looking for the deflection. Here's a chance to take the win, tucks it under the goal, and Belgium have won it in the final minute. Belgium get a third and steal all 3 points. It's going to finish Belgium 3, India 2.
Hinch comes off the line. Vitesse takes a wide. Oh, great save off the floor.
One would think that Vitesse had it, yes. Matty Hinch really trying her best to recover from that slip and fall. And she just throws the whole body at it and it happens to touch the stick.
Well, isn't that an example of full commitment? Absolutely right.
Schitterende schijnbeweging, waarna die Klaver in slaat stelt.
De Nooier. Langs George, even op de stick getikt. Nee, hij zit er zelfs in. Uitstekend voordeel gegeven van de scheidsrechter.
Farman close down, shoots! She shoots, she scores. No stopping that one. Marci Farman opens her account.
And smash.
As it comes. Farman takes it on, goes low this time. And all along the deck. And too good for a sporting goalkeeper. And the Dutch have got a 9.
All time for the Dutch to inflict further punishment on this gallant French team.
Here, there's Palmer. Beats the goalkeeper high to the keeper's left.
Poisins. It's saved. It's still mine. It's behind.
I think the Belgian team are going to go for a video referral here. But to me, it looks like it struck the postman on the right side of the goalkeeper.
I would stay with a penalty score. There was no clear advantage.
Got a chance to open his account. In the Hague 2014, Tom Bone levels the scores. High, strong, and effective for 1-1.
We might not see this penalty corner, but that's the fate. Bone drives it home for 2-2. Rossi 2, Bone 2, Belgium 2, Malaysia 2.
It's a great strike from Tom Bone. Probably not one of his best strikes in terms of placement. There's plenty of power behind it. Estuber probably won't be too happy with it by the looks of things. It just made its way through both clubs. You can see here, Bone just on a good whip behind it, and it's actually come off of his left glove, and it's pretty central. You have to say, as a goalkeeper, you've been definitely needing that, wanting to save those balls. Nonetheless, though, fires into the backboard here.
Here comes the ball in.
And a chance, they left it on. This time, that's surely the hat-trick for Tom Bone.
Ball comes across, a great slap across, takes a fortunate deflection from the Asian team. Tom Bone's in the right place, and from there, flicks it open side into the high stick side of the goalkeeper. The goalkeeper just gets a touch of it, but not enough to keep it out of the goal.
Still has a chance for a fourth goal, Tom Bone. No, no, maybe on the reverse. Oh, you cannot deny the man. He's number 27 from Belgium.
See a surge run by Dorman to pass the ball, and here initially coming off the Malaysian foot, good advantage. Kumar as well with a great save there, and again, falls back out. Shows individual trickery to get the ball up off the ground. Has another chance at it, and from here on the upright reverse, finishing into that bottom corner. A fantastic striker's goal, and of course, his fourth of the day.
And now down
Malema!
Side net.
No, it's in!
It's in.
It is in! How could she get it through that hole? Oh dear!
Reverse hit in. Bobley finds Dwyer. Off the back foot and into the back of the net. Jamie Dwyer opens the scoring here for Australia. Australia 1, France 0. Five times player of the year. Opening his account for Rick Charlesworth. Seven goals in total in the tournament now for Australia. Can they make it eight? Dwyer 1-on-1 with the keeper, lifts it over him and into the back of the goal. It's number two for Dwyer and it's number two for Australia. Australia 2, France 0.